if you'd have told me I'm the cook and the maid and the outside boy and the horse. And when all the month's up, that's it. What does you want I can tell you?
Well, we don't know what we're going to do just yet, Washington.
Yes, sir, yes, sir. I understand, sir. Of course, me don't make no difference about it. I'll be just as smart man himself with a little boy. And here I stay for 9
Oh, regard. That's fine, Washington.
Well, then I can start having coffee at that.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. That was an old pal of mine. Yeah, he'll be here in about a half hour. And from the way he talks, it looks like he's in the money. So it looks like my troubles are over.
That's great, Daddy.
Glad to hear. I don't know where he got the idea, but he seems to think I own this place. And you folks are my guests. Kind of a silly idea, isn't
it? Yes, funny.
Well, you would have done better if we just let it go at that and acted like we're.
Well, it won't hurt. He'll probably only be here a few days.
Well, you don't know, you know.
Okay, then, Johnny, that's the way to be.
Well, Daddy, here we are.
Gee, this is a swell place.
How long
will
be here?
Oh,
I know, Daddy. A couple months, maybe more.
It all depends. Oh, boy. Mr.
Johnny Martin's place.
Yes, sir. I expect you, Mr. King.
Yeah, that's right.
Well,
come on in, sir.
Mr.
Johnny's expecting you.
Thank
you. Come on, Daddy.
That's fine. Hello, Jim. Gee, it's great to see you again. You look swell.
You look so bad yourself, Daddy. Oh, Johnny, this is my sister's little boy, Danny Mason.
Hey, this is Mr. Danny.
Hello? Mrs. Clark, is it all right for him to be in here?
Sure, sure. Come on in. I want you to meet some friends of mine.
Thank you. Come on, Daddy.
Larry, I want you to meet a friend of mine. Jim Payne, and his nephew Danny Mason. Larry Gray. Excuse me, Carl the Great. How do you do?
How
are
you? Excuse me, Larry. Jim, I want you to meet a great lawyer from New York. Joe Farrell.
Oh, excuse me. Very glad to meet you, sir.
Cheers. And Miss Young, Mr. Kane. How do you do?
Not Clara Kimball Young.
That's right.
I'm very glad to meet you. You're always one of my favorites.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Kane.
Hello there.
Hello? And Mr. Bushman.
Bushman? Yes. Back to Bushman. I didn't know you anywhere. You haven't changed a bit.
Oh, I have grown a bit, have you?
Tell me, Mr. Bushman. There's something I've always wanted to know.
What's that, Mr. Kane?
Did you really hire that charity vendor?
Sure did.
Never had a double in my life.
Always did my own son.
That was a great race.
Oh, excuse me. Jim Jeffries.
Hello there. Don't get up. I met you a long time ago at Saratoga with Tex Mickey.
Oh, yes. I remember. I'm glad to meet you again.
Thank you, sir. Look, Johnny, I didn't know you were going to be so proud here with a barstool like this.
Oh, that's all right. There's always room for one more.
Hello there, young fella.
Hi, Mr. Bushman.
Here, Justin, let's go. Can you spell?
Sure.
Well, I'll come in.
What did
you do first? Go ahead and ask him. You buy some trunks in the dressing room.
We'll be right back.
All right.
Hello. Hello. What's your name? Daddy, this is George. Tell Father. Is that your dude? No, I'm staying in the hotel during the village. Oh, I thought I hadn't seen you before. What are you doing?
Writing a book.
Yeah? What's that?
Oh, my only favorite people around here. Mr. Young, Mr. Bushman, Mr. Jeffries.
Is this a fine for Jimmy, too?
Oh,
well, for Jim King. He's one of the best veterinarians in the world.
Is that so?
Yeah, don't you know him?
No, can't say I do.
Gee, that's funny. Everyone knows Jim King. He's a smart guy. You'll like him.
Will I?
You like him, too. You're pretty. If you were telling your daughter, you'd have me
brush. That's certainly a nice place to see you, Jimmy. I'm glad to see you take your money. You're smart.
Yeah. Remember my inaudible?
No.
That's her.
Hey, there's a nice little bull with her. Who's he by?
Judge Carl Pepper's promotion. The judge has the next farm. That 3-year-old is promotion call, too. They're full brothers.
Yeah? What do you call it?
Mr. Celebrity.
He looks good. You want anything with him?
No, I haven't started him yet. He's got a bad leg. Can't seem to pull it up.
You gotta do all right with a bloodline like that. You gotta have plenty of speed and stamina. Say, if you pick leg up while I'm here. She looks like reading my leg with a waist. Need to try?
What, Jim? Look at the disc. I don't own these horses any more than this place. It's why the wine is. And 5 years ago, he invited me to live here as long as I wanted. The same as those folks you met last night. I don't know why I wrote you all that story, except maybe, well, I know you got around a lot, and I didn't want the gang to think I was broke.
Look, Johnny, I've noticed great nowadays. Some of the richest men in the world are broke.
Good morning,
Charlie.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, sir.
Hi,
thanks.
How's
the book getting on?
Well, I thought it was just about just a bit, but several things I wanted to see.
Oh, all right. I'll get a chair.
Yeah.
Why don't you
find
out for
Jim? Come on. Yeah, but the worst of it is, Wade's estate holds a market
against me
for 350. And if I don't pay it,
Bingo
goes my room and board, and then I am in a jam. You haven't got 350 on you, have you, Jim?
Thanks for the compliment, Johnny. No, my bankroll is about 17 bucks.
You're welcome to that. Thanks, but I don't think that's
going to
do me much good.
When did you start pictures? In 1912? That's a long time ago, isn't it? I made my first pictures with a Vitagraph company. That was all the way back in New York, or a Flatbush, to be exact. In those days, we used to make 500 foot pictures and 1,000 foot pictures. And for 3 a week, you know. Well, those are hectic days. I remember the first 3-reeler we ever made was J.M. Barrie's The Little Minister. We thought that the audience would have sit through it, but they'd fall asleep. Did that well, did they? Oh, no, of course not, because right after that, we started making 5 real pictures.
So the lawyer said, the folks can stay here as long as they want. I can, too, if I pay up the note. But we have to pay the expenses of the place.
What do you expect to do here? Have they got any money?
Oh, I imagine all of them have some money, but we haven't talked it over yet.
Well, if I can have any help, got me in.
Okay.
Mr. Whitman, me going swimming with you. Is it okay?
Yeah, I guess so. Where are you going?
Fool.
We got a fool here?
Yeah, we've got everything but money.
Come on, I'll show you.
Well, you run along. I gotta make a couple long distance calls before they cut off the phone.
See you later. Come on, fella.
And Rudolph Valentino. Yes, he reflects me in front of it. But it was through that picture that he got his chance.
Yeah, listen,
that's marvelous. I've got that all. Now, I wish you could tell me something particular that occurred during the filming of the picture that you think people would be interested in reading about. Well, I know a lot of funny ones.
Bye.
That was open, in fact, so that's just what I want.
I'll think about it. See you later.
Yeah.
What?
She knows that too. You might as well admit it,
huh? Well,
bye.
Can't give me argument there either.
This is collaboration style.
You don't think
you're deep? No, but I will. I'm here all the time.
I just said,
Well, look, Poppy. I'm in a spot. Can you let me have 350?
Bushman,
you know I never made any money. I never
did.
Yes, but
you might. You invest in somebody else did it for me.
Oh, that's different. I'll say it, sir. You'll see what I see.
Yes, he's gonna grow up a bit, Tony, before he kills that bastard.
Well, so long, pal. Get me the U.S. Hotel, sir, so.
Oh, yes, please.
Say, that reminds me. You forgot to keep this card fixed.
So I did, Daddy. So I did.
Well, I'll be back.
All right, let's go. Okay, now, let's see your card, right? Yeah. I'll show you how it's done. Now, here, here's the back of the card. You see those? Oh, hold it, sir. You pick out the ones you see and give the others to me. Will you do that? Then you can see these. How's that?
Yeah,
all right, well, you'll see. That's much better. That's the same thing as the other, only a little bit bigger. See what I mean, Daddy?
Yeah.
Can you see all that, right?
Yeah.
Can you tell one card from the other?
Uh-huh.
Which is the other?
Yeah.
Here is the idea of the trick. Are you following me? Pick out one of those cards. Let me see, get one. Don't let me see it. You know what it is? You know what I got to call?
Yeah.
Put it back in the factory, right beside the neck. Now, shuffle them up. Back to them. Down. Here's the idea. You want to check your plate, don't like shopping cards, right there? You have a card today. See what I mean? Yeah. Here's the idea. We're going to find your card without the plate. Understand?
Yeah.
Here's the way you do it. We're not doing that. You say stop. Anytime you like. You know what I mean?
Right,
stop. 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 Why is it sitting there? Go there. What is it? You don't need anything. One is all you need. Ah, you need right hand. That's the point. On this side, that's right. Take your trouble. Put something in here. Here's the idea of the trick, Daddy. You put the keys of spades inside the back like that. Now put one finger on there. The sweet one, please. That's right. Now say, coming.
Coming.
Take it off there.
Did you win the championship? 9th of June, 1899. I beat Robert Fitzsimmons for the championship of the world.
How many thanks have you had?
Oh my gosh, I wouldn't be able to thank
you. Did you keep that
on? What was your last fight? I'm Tom Sharkey. I bought 25 rounds. The doctor announced several times. He'd roll over and get up, compare right after. We went 25 rounds and I got to the seat.
When did you? When did you first fight?
Oh, 1893.
You think you could have beat Joe Lewis?
Well, I think I beat better men than Joe Lewis. If I don't get going, I'll never get this game.
Oh, that's a mighty fine workout. What's my fault over there?
Yeah, Jim's been a good job.
Well, I think you're fine. Jim
Kane, just
broke up again. Oh, he did. I'm bad enough. You don't mean I have thought of a personal interest in that
celebrity, have you?
I'm only his father. Yes, I know. Like you've got to quit your
post anyhow. I think you're dropping into a race machine.
When you do, there'll be a couple of dollars of my money right on his nose.
I'm going to go.
Smokey?
Yeah?
Don't forget, you got plenty of horse with you today.
Yeah, let's get the name, Mr. Kane.
Yeah. Ha-ha, that's not for you. Maybe
after you win the race, I'll give you one. Stay forth until
you hit the far turn. Then
let him
roll. Okay. It's lucky. Stay for him now. It's
pretty kinder. All right, Sherry,
I'll let him. All right. Make you feel any better?
This race means a lot to all of us, Smokey. If you win, this one's the right in the Southern Handicap next week.
Okay. But you know you're not supposed to feed him anything before the race. It'll give him colic. Gosh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It's too late to be sorry now. You should have thought of that in the first place. Anyone with a mission don't know better than that. Why don't you just warm up? Gee, Carol, I didn't mean to talk to you like this. I guess I just a little excited.
That's all right, Daddy. Suppose I deserve worse than that?
But I better tell you. No, don't do that yet. That would be a shock too. Let's just hope celebrity wins anyhow.
Whatever you say, Danny.
I'm thinking, telling how I talk to you. That would be a shock too. Okay, let's
go. Good luck, Sophie.
Thank you. You're gonna need it.
Oh, no. Oh, no. How is he? It is a bit strange.
Here he comes.
Here he is.
Oh, he's the prettiest one there.
Oh, boy, not a big guy.
They're off. Beans and eggs. It all depends on what horse I'm going to fix. But I always had plenty to eat. I never was sick. Anything like that. Take good care of me, dears.
Oh, goody, goody. You look fine.